Well, we have officially had the biggest bank runs in history, and tomorrow it gets worse. And just to think about it for a second, four nice large-sized banks have went down in less than 30 days. And cue the fire a second time. Let's play a little game. I'm gonna drop down a set. Skylar, can you lower the screen, please?
Sure, boss. I just can never figure out, like, which button is it?
Actually, buddy, the question that I have for you is, what the hell are you wearing?
Well, boss, my mom says I have to be more fashion-forward now that I'm on the air more often, so I purchased myself an Hermes shawl. I think they're called a shawl.
Well, I don't even know either of those words that you just spoke of, but push, yeah, that's the button. And then you gotta, okay, all right, everyone, you're gonna have to, sorry, Skylar, I gotta just drop you on the floor. You cannot laugh. If you laugh or break a smile, you owe me a like. You ready? Here's our administration on this whole banking collapse. Biden says, banks in pretty good shape. Now, I actually fell out of the floor when I was reading that. And not only that, we have video. Also, I want you to watch her.
Not in consternation, number one. Look, I think we've done a pretty damn good job. People's savings are secure. And even those
people's savings are secure. Poof. I mean, that is clearly, hold on. Can I zoom in on this? That is clearly either you're gonna be eating something or something bad is about to take place. Either way, the way your hands are positioned, I wouldn't suggest you do it. Oh, and just in case you want to see the rate of change going back to as far as I could go with what is going on in the banking system right now, it looks like that. That is the worst ever. The worst amount of outflows out of one bank and into another. It's kind of like you're the frog being boiled, you jump out, and then you end up in the fire. Also, another chart showing the commercial bank deposits going in the wrong direction. Currents, well, cash, the digits, everything that is in the system, it looks really bad. It's starting to disappear. Someone needs to call Janet and tell her to start burring. But there's your big banks and small banks. Look, just that red line just keeps going. I mean, even if I adjust my elevator, it still keeps going and going, and it's all gone. And the article says domestic commercial banks saw, I'm just rounding, just for good measure, $100 billion in deposit outflows. That to just over $17 trillion, eighth straight week. But I'm sure everything is fine now. They have new tools. And these new tools, I want to be this tool maker. This guy's making some money. Always new tools. They don't work. As small banks see the biggest deposit outflow forever since the birth of baby Jesus. Oh, but I will want to say there is some good news in all of this. These guys are in charge. So you could just rest assured that these two right here will take care of everything. Everything is fine. Wait until this chat show. A U.S. debt crisis. That's next. Coming up next on End of the World. U.S. debt crisis will arrive sooner as banking turmoil hits the economy. Yeah, you haven't hit the bad part of the economy yet. We're getting there. Again, first inning of the economy and federal revenue. Oh, that's disappearing too. So basically, that debt ceiling, I just say, don't raise it. I mean, that will be the black swan event. Like, that black swan basically is just sitting on our lap. We're like, hey, buddy, you our new pet? That will take down this entire chat show that you've been wanting to take down. And just to think about it, as if you already don't owe enough out of your taxes, it's gonna be going up. $31 trillion, that's a lot of bonds with a lot of interest, and we are totally upside down on our deficit. And not just that, our GDP of 120, after 80, you might as well just kiss it all goodbye. But it's okay, they have new tools that will fix this called raising your taxes. Because that is how the system is played, and also coming in from more bad news. Hey, it's a chart. The green lines is a recession. I'm going to get to that in just a second. But these are financial conditions. These are banks lending, okay? And I just wanted to show you, it's really not that bad yet. But you wait until we get a green bar. If you watched yesterday's video, I talked about how recessions and correlated with the stock market, Stock market goes down every single time, somewhere between 5 to 10% to 50%. So when I come onto this channel and I say, we're not there yet, we are in the first inning, I just want to show you the financial conditions. We're in the first inning. So, and just in case you want to see if you were just for some reason trading financial conditions, you would be looking at the MACD, which, you see, when these two cross right there, I'll make it bigger for you because I can on camera, but not in real life. Those two are going to cross and zoom up. Also, on the RSI, if you are trading this, you are in an upward momentum above or on the 50. So let's do this. And a lot of you guys ask me in the comment, am I too late to this party? Can I make money shorting? Can I make money trading? The answer is yes. It's, again, first inning. See that blue line? That's where we're at. See, going back to the 70s, right? The 80s, the 2000s, the great financial collapse, what we just went through. So you have not seen anything yet. That's why I'm saying take advantage of everything that's in my brain. Because when you do, you're going to go, wait a minute, I'm confused. Why'd the stock market go up? Well, the same reason why I put in a long at the beginning of the week. I think it was the beginning of the week. On the S&P 500, it's because the charts. You just follow the charts, and that's then you get to win. But four banks have collapsed in less than a month. What do these dudes have to say? Well, I'll show you. Here's what Jerome Powell, well, we already know. Elon, what's Elon? What are you saying about it, said Elon? And I mean, we already know what Jerome's going to say. Oh, you get 25 basis points, everything's great. You got Noriel Rubini says it's like the Bermuda Triangle. Yeah. How about it? How about the other billionaire? Elon, this is a serious risk. This is a serious risk, which are kind of like the words that the captain said when he hit the iceberg on the Titanic. Yep. This is a serious risk. Carson, these risks are right under the noses. I know, every single time. And they just do it every single time. The same thing. But no. We have new tools. You see, we're going to go over there and change the name of these things, like MILF, where the Treasury creates bonds. That's not new. You've been doing this the whole time. Yes, but did you notice that it sounds different? Which on this one, they call it the Emergency Lending Facility. Same thing. It's all just loans backed by you. And for those of you that saw, the Fed's balance sheet do that, right? Okay. See, it went up and everyone's like, oh my gosh. Well, those are called assets, my friend. See, total assets, right? Those are loans. A loan is an asset. Asset to the Fed, liability to you and the government because you have to pay it back with interest. So that is what is happening. And the good news is U.S. authorities are considering expanding all of this. Yay! And passing it on to you. As this article, U.S. mulls more support for banks while giving First Republic time. It's okay, you guys, take your time. While I sit over here and I make money from it, or I teach you, oh, you got more than 250 in there? Well, you're gonna, it's gone, it's all gone. So make sure, we'll talk to your financial advisor, because I cannot tell you, I can just tell you 250, that's all they got. Move it into a money market, move it into something else. I don't care, move it into gold, move it into silver, move it into Bitcoin, move it into sheets of paper that look like this. You got to move the digits. I mean, on the money market, this is actually do have a Fidelity. You name the account, I got one. They're paying what? On the 1 year, 2%, 2.1, 2.2, 2.4. Or you can call your bankster and say, hey, you know, I saw there's a 1 year. See, if you would rewind the tape when it was above 5%, I'm making phone calls, locking that 5.1, 5.1, 1 year, 1 year, 5.1 on a treasury. T-bill, but you gotta call your bank. And if your bank's like, oh, we don't know how to do that, you should probably move to a different bank. But now they've actually collapsed just in a week. Now it's 4.3. Actually, the 2 year that the Fed follows, 3.7, that was in the five. You went from the fives to the threes and the Fed is still tightening. What? But as you guys are moving and shaking and moving the money and shaking your booty, maybe, I don't know what your side job, everyone needs a side hustle. I can't, you know. No judgment here. Investors brace for another week of turmoil as Mad March ends. Remember, sell in May and go away. So you guys have made all your money from the beginning of the year, March, April, May. Oh, wait. No, you've lost money? Well, Imagine how bad it's going to get. And it is globally too. The yen wipes out year's loss amid haven demand, but that's comparative to the dollar, which I need to go into the dollar, comparative to Bitcoin, because one goes up, one goes down. But what about this, Bravo? What's the dollar do in a recession? Oh, I'm glad you asked. I'll show you. But global financial markets are poised for another week of turmoil as traders close out a dizzying month in which worries about U.S. European leaders dominate sentiment, send me a mint, and complicated central banks fight against inflation. And man, dominated sentiment was in two words. Those never put those together. My brain was like, dominate. Now put an ED on the end. Dominate. Thank goodness you don't come here for my intelligence or my ability to read at a kindergarten level. But what I want to show you something is a chart. It is it looks like a wedge, but it's going upwards and it's broadening, all right? This is what happened on the dollar. And this, when I said, if it breaks that line, it's going to keep going down until it finds, well, the support or the price objective. And the dollar is very important. It's also part of this bond thing that we all seem to be in. The dollar, sheets of paper, bonds. This is actually just a small bond that you guys use. It is a debt-based system. But if you were to rewind the tape, and back in November, coming into December, I would say, if it breaks that little blue line, your price target is that dotted line there. You're gonna wanna exit, or you're gonna wanna make money going up, and then right click, short or sell, and make money going down. Also, when it goes down in a rather quick fashion, but that was your shot over the bow. Well, since then, right? And the correlation between the dollar and Bitcoin, gold, and silver. It correlated, but they go in the opposite direction. So when the dollar goes up, Bitcoin goes down. When the dollar goes down, well, Bitcoin goes up. Now, the question you may have is, well, Bravo, how well does Bitcoin do in a recession? Well, the little one that we had, it dropped it down to 3,800. Now, I can go back in the charts, and I'm not saying it's going to go there. These are just probabilities. I've been saying on the show, if you want to accumulate anything under 20, okay. Anything above that, you probably should have waited. Also, on the dollar, that's another price target. This is called support. And I think we're going to go all the way down there and retest it. When? I don't know. These are just plays. But now you're like, well, what happens in a recession? Well, I will show you. On the dollar, during a recession, right during it and then exiting it. So that's basically just a heartbeat. And that is why I trade it. So that one, you'd basically just be flat. Maybe you'd be up. Bravo, what happened during the great financial collapse? Because I think that's what's going to happen. Well, the dollar started here, okay, in the recession, and ended up actually moving up. Now, these are not, I know you're like, wow, look at these swings. It's only 5%. And now going back to 2000, you came in right here, and then you exited there. See? What kind of correlation? But look at the swing. Well, how about the 90s? What was that? Well, it was beginning of the 90s. That's where you entered. That's where you came out of it. 3%. But ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is why I swing trade. And this is actually on the weekly. See, I get in and then I get out. Now, on this one, so 1990s. Okay, you can just go back and it's the same thing. I just do this. This is what I do every single day. Well, in a bear market, a little bit different. All right. Also, if you want the discount, grab it down below. Let me draw this line. That would be, what are we doing? 60% off my swing trading. So grab that. That would be your entry point. See how the MACD right there? Also, my bear market, 60% off. That would be the second course you do, where you can do all my courses that I've ever done since the beginning of time. That's $199 for payments. So I'll do this while I'm sounding like a used car salesman. All right, so that is where you're going to exit. You're going to enter here. See the swing on the MACD? You're going to exit there. That's it. You swing up, you take your profit. Now, are you going to get the very bottom? No. Did you get the very bottom? No, you got close to it. Did you get the very top? No. And then let me just turn on my little Bravo 9 that comes in the swing trading course. Yes, you have little buy and sell indicators that will pop up. Buy. This one, this MACD confirmation, you wouldn't have, I don't think you would have sold. Nah, yeah, that would have been up to you. But you'd go buy here, you come up here, you sell right there. That is the Bravo 9. And yes, it works on the weekly, because some people are like, do I have to trade every day? No, you can trade on the weekly. I mean, how long? You would have entered this position in February and then exited in July. You could do the same thing on the SPY. You can do it on the DIA. That's the Dow. Everything, especially major indices. Where, you know, you don't, I'm not like OTCs where there's, you know, market manipulation, wouldn't do that. But the big ones, you're just, you move up, you move down, you move up, you move down. For me, I would prefer, I trade on the daily, I trade on the 4 hour, if you have time. On the S&P 500, that was your confirmation where those two on the MACD, yep, they converged, they diverged. I actually put in a lot, that was this week, and it bounced off the 200. So if you're looking at the charts, you got to do what the charts say. And no, it's not like 100% of the time. But I'll tell you, you'll probably do a lot better than these financial analysts out there and everyone, you know, the talking heads. Oh, just look at the charts. You don't even have to listen to the noise. And these guys are struggling at trading this. This is a tough one. I know. Congratulations. If you're in it, this is hard because you have a recession. We're staring at it. And what do markets do in a recession? They sell off. So you know I'm not going to be buying and hodling this SPY position that I took out on the channel. I mean, the only thing that I've been hodling for the last, I don't know, however many months is bonds. That's it. Just hodl the bonds. I'll get to that in a second. But yeah, moving your money, get 5-point-something%. Free money. Okay, I'll take it. I mean, I got to beat them to it because that's what you do when you deposit your money is they then deposit in the bond market or they loan it out or they buy mortgage backed securities, which I would not recommend. Recession. This is what's staring right at our face. Bank failures and stagnant stock returns. Experts see a new difficult era dawning for markets. And I say it's not difficult. Just follow these lines and also understand some macro. And that's why maybe you've thought, right? It's on your side. Hey, you're like, maybe this guy is, I mean, he looks like an idiot, but there's something in his brain. Maybe, who knows? But if you can understand the macro picture, it's gonna give you an advantage because you're gonna look out the window and you're gonna see those clouds. And where I'm at, I can see clouds and I can see rain. So I can see rain coming through the clouds and it's approaching me. So, I mean, it might dissipate. Maybe it'll burn off. Probably not. But bond traders go all in. Yeah, me too. They go all in on recession bets. See, the bond market is your recession play. That's actually defying these guys, the politicians that say the banks are fine. Jerome, right? Jerome says everything is perfectly fine. Also, as you know, in the bond market, if you want to purchase these bonds, you can, one, call a bank or you can trade TLT. And again, you could play the same thing. It's this, the MACD right here. This is where you enter, right? Right there. Okay. That's also, this is in my bear market course. This is a triangle. That is not in my swing trading course because it gets too complicated. But look. You would buy here. And actually, a lot of people on this channel bought in here and actually made a lot of money. And I said, that's a double bottom, guys. I think that's the lowest you're going to see TLT. And well, I was right on that play. Trust me, I've been wrong on TLT. That is because I did not follow the charts. I just looked at macro. But it's nice to have macro. But if you want to know what's going on in this, look at these swings. Like, come on. That's all it does is swing. But you broke the 200 on TLT. Bull market. Okay, then you're going to break that little orange line right there. And then you're going to have a price target that is way up there. And as Biden would say, you're about 1 inch from making it. And also, like what I've told my wife, I can do a lot with 1 inch. I'm just saying. This is the 200-day moving average. This is one candle above the 200-day moving average. Or should I say full body? That's what we look, you know, for you drinkers. You want that full body. One full body. I know it's red. Apologize for that. One above that one. Now just get above that orange line. See, I said, I think it's going to come down. Find support retest, then we go higher. So come and join me in this fire, and let's take advantage of every single play in this. And let's stop listening to people that are like, banks, they're all in pretty good shape. Well, you can see how your voice just escalated. That when I worked law enforcement, that was a clear sign that you're lying, or when you hit your nose or you blink a lot. At the end of the day, the best thing for you is to take this education, like stuff that you can actually use in life. Like maybe just that. You're like, you know, my wife does blink a lot. She does itch her nose. I did notice her voice went up when I asked her that question about, what is this on the credit card? Oh, babe, I don't know. Right? That was clearly Skylar on that one. But thank you guys for making it to the end. I love you. Take advantage of whatever discounts I am running while I raise the prices of all of my courses. Because hyperinflation. Peter Schiff said it, so I have to follow the lead. And I'll see you tomorrow.